Dear professional friends, in this video I am going to discuss three topics. Form GNL1, extension of AGM. Is it made to be as a STP form? Should it be made as an STP form? The Register of Companies may an application made to it by way of filing of a form of GNL1. The certified true copy of the board resolution or general meeting resolution extend the period of the holding of annual general body meeting for a period not exceeding 3 months. Companies are not allowed to make an application for extension of time for the post-general annual general meeting, and therefore non-holding of first AGM will be a non-compliance of the section 96 of the Companies Act 2013, and the company will be liable for penal provision. So non-holding of first AGM will be a liable for penal provision. So there is no extension for available for first AGM. For a subsequent AGM, there is a extension is available if it is applied through the form GNL1. Under the MMCA, under the General Circular 28-2020 dated 17th August 2020, COVID-19 scenario, not extended the time for the filing of holding the AGM, but it has made a circular to file GNL1 form for extension of AGM up to 31st December 2020. And the extension will be granted generally. It instructed ROCs, all the ROCs in India, to grant extension of AGM to those companies which have supplied GNL1 liberally and in view of hardship faced by the stakeholders, and to grant extension for the period of applied for up to 3 months in such situation. However, due to administrative reasons, regional ROCs may delay their approval for the extension of AGM. In spite of COVID-19 and in spite of advice by the government, liberally extend the AGM if it is asked for by through GNL1. Many ROCs may delay it. So in such a situation, stakeholders may have to apply to NCLT only. They have to approach to NCLT if there no extension has been given by the ROC. To avoid such situation in the COVID-19 scenario, it is requested that MCA should come forward to make a GNL form as STP form. So straight through form. GNL form is now under the approval route. It should be made as a STP form, so that those companies which apply a GNL will automatically get the extension up to 31st December 2019. Avoid the long delay caused by any ROC office in India, and it will help the stakeholders under this COVID-19 situation. Friends, next is, can balance sheets be signed digitally? Will that be acceptable? Under Information Technology Act, documents signed digitally is acceptable, and IT Act prevails over the other. SEBI specifically allowed use of digital signatures by issuing circular up to December 31st, 2020. These days, video conferencing, electric voting and electric records are becoming a norm. In this digital environment, it is important to understand about the authenticity and validity of the signing of various documents digitally by the director of the company. Present Information Technology Act 2000 provides for recognition of electronic digital signatures. However, there is a limited reference to the digital signatures in other acts like Companies Act 2013 and Indian Evidence Act 1872. Signing by means of digital signature is optional, but in certain cases it is mandatory to validate electronic records through digital signature. Companies Act 2013, as per sub-rule 1 of the Rule 8 of Companies Registration Office under Fees Rules 2014, an electronic form shall be authenticated by authorized signatories using a digital signature. Further, as per section sub-rule 6, a scanned image of document shall be of the original signed documents relevant to the e-forms or forms, and the scanned document image shall not be left blank without bearing the actual signature of the authorized person. Further, the electronic signature or digital is also now recognized in the Indian Evidence Act 1972 and Information Technology Act 2020. documents which cannot be signed digitally. As per first schedule of Information Technology Act 2000, for the following document and transaction, the provisions of the Act shall not be applicable. A negotiable instrument act other than a check, as defined in Section 1 of the Negotiable Instrument Act 1881, a power of attorney as defined in Section 1A of the Powers of Attorney Act 1882, a trust as defined in Section 3 of the Indian Trust Act 1882, a will as defined in the of Section 2 of the Indian Succession Act 1925, including any other testamentary disposition by whatever name called, any contract for the sale or conveyance of immovable property or any interest in such property. There can always exist some doubts in the mind of user of digital signature, as the law does not prescribe elaborate procedure and its eligibility or its recognition in under the Act. Therefore, it is very important that government should come forward under this COVID-19 situation with a clear-cut detailed guidelines in this regard, and especially in these times of lockdown, for using electronic digital signatures under various acts by directors or any other professionals of or in relation to their company. So this is very important. Government should come forward and explain whether digital signatures signed by the directors and the professionals will be recognized as under the Evidence Act and Information Technology Act under Companies Act. That will help the companies in long way to come over these situations that they are facing under the COVID-19 situation. Friends, third is MCA deadline approaching for 30th September 2000. The 30th September is a very important date. A lot of deadlines as prescribed by the MCA is coming on. Let us see what are the forms that has to be filed on 30th September 2020. LP 11, annual return of LLP, this is the last date is 30th September 2020. Pass 6, reconciliation of share capital audit report, 13th September 2020. Bend 2, disclosure of significant beneficial owner, 30th September 2020. DIR 3 KYC, KYC of directors, 30th September 2020. MS form MSME, delay in payment to MSME vendor, 30th September 2020. DPT 3, return of deposit, 30th September 2020. CFS scheme, 2020 scheme, waiver of late fees for firms, 30th September. See, this is very important. CFS 2020 scheme is going to expire by 30th September 2020. Those companies which has not availed this scheme, it is in their interest, it is advised to avail the scheme and file pending forms without any further delay, as CFS 2020 may come to an end on 30th September, and after that companies have to pay heavy penalty to MCA for filing pending forms. Friends, I think this will be very useful for you, and if you like this, please I request you to subscribe my channel, so that whenever, and also press the bell button which is very near to the subscribe button, so that it whenever if I issue a new video on any new topic, it will reach you directly. Thanking you, RV Shekhar, practicing company secretary.